Hi, and welcome to the Elements of FAIR video series. We will now talk about what it means to make research outputs FAIR, meaning findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. This tutorial focuses on findability of data. In the context of FAIR, data should be understood as a broad concept that can refer to data, metadata, software, code, models, and other documentation that makes research reproducible. All these elements need to be findable, but only the discovery metadata needs to be openly available. It should contain information about the access to the content. For your research outputs to be findable, they have to be visible and understandable for humans as well as for machines. They should be assigned a globally unique, persistent, and resolvable identifier. Be described with rich discovery metadata, and ideally be deposited in a trusted data repository. A trusted data repository will give your data or other content a persistent identifier. It also helps providing necessary discovery metadata in formats that are accessible for both humans and machines. But let's look closer at these requirements. Persistent identifiers, or PIDs for short, are long-lasting globally unique references to any kind of resources or their digital representations on the internet, such as publications, datasets, metadata, websites, scientific samples, funding bodies, persons, software, services, concepts, or anything else you need to refer to in a persistent way. Examples of PIDs include the digital object identifier DOI, handle, archival resource key, open researcher and contributor ID ORCID, or for example research organization registry. Note that not all resources you produce during your research will need a PID. In general, those that underpin published findings or objects that have longer-term value are worth assigning a PID. It can also be a good idea to publish content you created but did not use yet or will not use. Although there are many kinds of different persistent identifiers, the basic concept remains the same. A PID identifies one unambiguous object and is linked to metadata, which explains the object. The object can, for example, be a dataset which has been assigned a DOI, and the linked metadata should describe all parts of the dataset, their licensing and access restrictions. The metadata of the dataset could also refer to other research outputs like articles or code. Remember that the PID itself does not guarantee the quality of the object. Anyone can, for example, get a DOI from Zenodo for their files. In shallow FAIR, the minimum requirement is that a published dataset has machine-actionable metadata and a PID. The creators should also be unambiguously identifiable with PID to give credit to the correct person. A researcher can, for example, be identified with ORCID, and articles can be given DOI or URN. In deep FAIR, as many as possible of the data elements are machine-actionable, and hence, they can be interlinked directly with similar datasets and their elements. But why are PIDs important and so useful? Online resources change over time, and ordinary hyperlinks are unreliable when pages are moved or content updated. The latter is called content drift. Link rot or link death means that old hyperlinks do not refer to an active page. This happens when resources like data or metadata are moved or deleted. PIDs make it possible to find a particular resource consistently over time and avoid link rot as well as content drift. The PID owner maintains and governs the content behind the PID, and the PID provider will guarantee that the PID is sustainable. Possible changes in the content are documented in the metadata. If the content behind the PID is removed, a tombstone page must be maintained. It can include a new PID directing to another version of the object. The service is offered by a trusted repository. A persistent identifier alone is not enough to make the data findable. You need to provide discovery metadata as well. This metadata should be open information. A good description in the metadata makes it easier for others to understand what your data is about and potentially reuse it. Discovery metadata should contain information about the following topics. Descriptive core information such as a persistent identifier, the title of the dataset, publication and/or creation date, field of science, keywords, creators, contributors, abstract about the content, data lineage, publisher, and technical information like checksum, size, and file formats. Secondly, there needs to be administrative information about rights, such as license, possible access restrictions and restriction grounds, embargo time, rights and data owners, contact for reuse, as well as how to apply for use permit and access if these are needed. And third, structural metadata that describes how the dataset is organized internally and how it relates to other datasets such as older versions or relevant related publications. In addition to discovery metadata, you should provide detailed or data-level metadata and documentation about your data to make it interoperable, reusable, and reproducible. You can find more information about this in the interoperable episode of this FAIR Elements video series. Although discovery metadata is open, your data can be either open or available with restrictions if necessary. This should be stated in terms of use in the administrative discovery metadata and include a machine actionable license. When you publish your dataset in a data repository, preferably in a data type specific place, the repository guides you to provide the discovery metadata they support or provides it for you. You can also use generic or not data type specific data repositories to publish data. If you, for example, use the FAIR Data services for publishing data, you are guided to provide suitable discovery metadata by the Kuvain tool. And once the description is ready, the information will be published in ETSIN. You can also get familiar with data papers, which are peer-reviewed documents describing a dataset, published in a peer-reviewed journal. Data and metadata that computers can process correctly facilitates research. Machine actionability makes your outputs visible for search engines or services like Google or Web of Science. Your data will reach a larger audience and have better chances to be reused and cited. Making discovery metadata machine actionable is the responsibility of the data repository. However, it is your responsibility as a researcher to select a data repository that enables that. Making data findable is easy if you plan ahead and find a suitable service for publishing your data. It is important that you get a persistent identifier and have sufficient discovery metadata. This way your data can be found, cited, and your data is sustainably linked to the article, authors, the publisher, and funding authority. Making data available also improves the reproducibility and reliability of the research. Thank you for watching.